Welcome to part one of an eight-part program in shared parenting. In part one, we'll start off by looking at the definition of shared parenting, and then we're going to get involved in looking at who it actually applies to. Finally, we're going to look at the legal and social context of shared parenting.
So what is shared parenting? Well, shared parenting is where both parents take an active role in the upbringing of their children.
Now, upbringing, what I'd like to do is really expand upon what the meaning of upbringing is. Obviously, it's going to involve the education of the children, their moral and physical being, the resources involved in parenting children, where they're going to live, the houses, where they are in respect to their friends, what we're going to do about holidays, what we're going to do about birthdays, all the elements of a child's life and the parenting involved within it.
Norman has raised a number of important issues there. The shared parenting program designed by Parental Equality is a set of tools to enable parents to put together a shared parenting plan.
What we're going to do within the program is we're actually going to enable you to develop this plan, and the plan's going to be something which both parents need to be able to live with. It's got to be practical, it's got to be sustainable, there are a number of models, and obviously it's going to have to be child friendly.
Previous participants on this program have found that this is an effective tool to enable them to share parenting successfully.
Can I ask a question here? Is this shared parenting program for married people? Or does this only apply to separated people? Do you have to have been married for shared parenting to work? What about if you're never married? For example, if you're an unmarried father, who is this for?
That's an interesting question, and it's one that's arisen on many of our past courses. Who does shared parenting apply to? What parents shouldn't forget is that parents are forever.
But what does that mean in terms of parents are forever? What does that mean in terms of who's shared parenting for them?
Well, shared parenting is applicable to everybody. In fact, in parental equality, we believe that if parents supported the concept of shared parenting from the birth of the child, that it would actually strengthen the mutual respect between the parents. It would give the children a better understanding of how to parent themselves eventually. And obviously, in the event there was an unfortunate breakdown in relationship, there's no reason whatsoever that they wouldn't be able to continue to jointly parent those children themselves.
If 40% of children are born outside of wedlock, is this for unmarried fathers too?
Shared parenting is for all parents and children, be it that you're a married couple, a separating couple, or an unmarried couple.
But if I'm an unmarried father, how do I even start to have a relationship with my child?
Even if you weren't living with the mother at the time of the birth of the child or after the birth of the child, you're still the father of that child. What this program is about is supporting you and the mother in developing a parenting role for you with that child and negotiating a continuing role in the parenting of that child with the mother going forward.
But can I ask, the word or term shared parenting, is this a legal term? Has it any meaning in terms of social policy, in terms of the legal system? What happens if people separate and there's a custody battle, for example? What happens in courts?
Shared parenting per se doesn't have a legal status. What does have a legal status in Ireland is joint custody. Joint custody is the norm in many countries. In fact, in Ireland, since 1997, in the Children's Act, joint custody is a specific option available to a judge adjudicating in a family child custody issue.
If I'm an unmarried father, can I get joint custody even though I'm not a guardian?
There's a difference here between guardianship and custody. Custody in this country is what's determined as the day-to-day care and control. Guardianship is the right to have a say in the social, physical, moral and educational welfare of a child.
So in order to be able to gain joint custody, the first thing you'll have to do is achieve guardianship. Now that's available to you either voluntarily with the mother, or you can actually end up going to the court. And by the way, in all countries, and most particularly in Ireland, the family court system must uphold the welfare of the children as being paramount when deciding on an issue of child welfare. So from a legal and social point of view, the best solution is to have joint custody backed up by a mutually agreed parenting plan.
During part one, we looked at the definition of shared parenting. We also looked at who does it actually apply to. Finally, we looked at the social and legal context of shared parenting.
Now that we've discussed the meaning of the terms, what do you think the benefits of shared parenting are? To find out, join us for the second part of the Shared Parenting Programme.